So let's wrap up what we've learned in this unit. Strings are just sequences of characters, and manipulating strings is going to be critically important for making a web browser. Modern programming languages support regular expressions, which are just a concise notation for specifying sets of strings. And using regular expressions is more flexible than using fixed string matching like string.find. With regular expressions, we can define phone numbers, words, numbers, quoted strings. And given a regular expression, we can search for and match it in a bigger string. Finite state machines are a pictorial equivalent to regular expressions. Every regular expression, concatenation, plus, question mark, star, has an equivalent finite state machine. And in fact, although I didn't show it, vice versa. Every regular expression has a finite state machine, and every finite state machine has a regular expression. And then every finite state machine can be converted to a deterministic finite state machine. No epsilons, no ambiguity. Once we have a deterministic finite state machine, we can simulate it. And it turns out it's very easy, about 10 lines of recursive code, to see if a deterministic finite state machine accepts a string. In fact, you've written that code. Now that you know how to implement regular expressions, take the regular expression, make a finite state machine, make it deterministic, call fsmsim. We'll just use Python's regular expression library, but it's doing exactly those steps under the hood. It works the same way you would. In our next exciting episode, we're going to use this knowledge to specify important parts of HTML and JavaScript, like string constants or hypertext tags, as the first step to writing our web browser. One great resource available to you as you revise this material and work on the homework is the forums. Be sure to check them out. If you are wondering about something, almost certainly someone else was wondering as well. Post your question, others will benefit from seeing it answered. Be courteous, but be curious. We all benefit from questions. And let me just leave you with this XKCD comic. While they're talking about Perl, everything said applies to Python, and soon you will be using regular expressions to save the world.